here in At Sarabia's gym in Pico Rivera, California, catching up with super lightweight contender Arnold Barboza. He's taking on Manny Lopez on December 14th in Corpus Christi on the Surdo Ramirez Jesse Hart undercard. Arnold, how's everything going? You getting ready for this upcoming fight?
Everything's going great. We were originally getting ready for November 4th. That card fell through, and they told us Corpus Christi's on 14th. And we were ready to go. I mean, training camp has been good. Even using sparring, it's been going good.
Recently, you did not know who your opponent's name. You're taking on Manny Lopez, a fighter from Colorado with a record of 14-2. Two losses by decision. You guys have an opponent in common, Johnny Rodriguez. What else do you know about Manny Lopez come December 14th?
I just know that Manny Lopez is a tough fighter. You know, he's a real tough fighter. He's real experienced. He had a good amateur career. We're excited. You know, like we said, we got to keep taking steps forward. This is an exciting fight for me. This has a little more meaning for me.
Why is that?
You're moving up the ranks. Just moving up, I got ranked number 8 by the WBO now, so I gotta, put an exclamation point on it. It's gonna be a televised fight on ESPN. I don't know if it's gonna be opening bout or co-main, but I'm very excited. My promoter Top Rank is the best in the world. They've been taking me up and treating me good, and ready to go.
So. The matchmakers at Top Rank, Arnold, since we're becoming familiar, I've covered some of your fights. Bruce Trampler, legendary matchmaker, and Brad Goodman. They've been keeping a close eye on all your fights. You're pretty close to a top 10 contender, probably a co-main event. You've been keeping an eye on all those super lightweight world champs. Jose Ramirez, Maurice Hooker is taking on Alex Saucedo tomorrow. Your thoughts on that fight tomorrow night?
We're rooting for Saucedo. He's top ranked.
Friday,
and,
actually.
And hopefully he brings the belt, basically brings the belt home, you know. But Ramirez is a good fighter. His last fight, he really impressed me. I think he stepped up his game, and the Hooker fight is going to be a great fight, But we're not worried about any of that, Manny Lopez is what we're worried about. After Manny Lopez, we could talk about anything else. But other than that, we're ready for the 14th.
A lot of the fight fans, they were a little disappointed that they couldn't get to see your fight streamed for your last performance. What happened that night?
I believe what happened was we were set to go on, but I guess one of Top Rank's guys from Brazil, I guess Brazil had paid for his TV time, so he had to go on. So it wasn't enough time for me to go on, so they left me to the end. But I mean, it was cool. I mean, I didn't care. We don't care. My team, we didn't care. We said as long as we get the win and get out of there, we're good.
You put a hurt on Luis Solis that night. What worked so well for you in Glendale, Arizona?
You know what? My training and everything has just I took it to the next level. My dedication to the sport has just been way different than even when I fought Mike Reed. I've dedicated myself to the sport way more than I have in the past, and I think it showed. I personally thought Solis was going to be a tougher fight. Everyone did, because he's a tough.
Going to be a tougher fight.
He's a tough guy. I mean, he's dropped a lot of people. He's strong,
Taller as well.
Taller, yes. About 6'1", to me, it wasn't an easy fight because of all the training I had to go through, but fight time, it wasn't what I expected, put it that way. I think it was the training that really helped me, and it got me more hungry. I was back in the gym that Monday, moving around, and that fight really it really boosted my level of confidence.
Are you trying to make a statement on December 14th, making sure the matchmakers, the fight fans, let them know that Arnold Barboza is ready for that top contending a challenger in the super lightweight division?
Of course, we're gonna try to make a statement, but. We're not gonna do anything out of the, what we haven't been doing. We're just gonna fight our fight, fight our fight, do what we do. And we've been working on some new things in the gym. We wanna make a statement, but we're just gonna be us, and we're gonna let it happen.
The fact that you're fighting, you just said it, you might be the co-main event for the Surdo Ramirez-Jesse Hart rematch. Did you see the first fight? What do you think of this event overall?
Yeah, you know, I seen the first fight of Zuro and Jesse Hart, and man, those guys went at it. You know, I think it was like Zuro hurt him in the beginning, and he hurt him. I don't know. But it was a crazy fight. It was a potential fight of the year. So to be on that undercard, you know, TV or not, you know, it's a blessing. You know, it's a blessing, and we're ready to go. You know, I just want to thank, you know, Brad Goodman and you know, Top Rank and everybody for believing in me and letting me showcase my skills.
How proud is your parents so far of your accomplishment in the sport?
Well, pretty proud. I mean, my dad doesn't say too much, but I know he is, you know. But, you know, we haven't really done anything, to tell you the truth. You know, our goal, you know, is to be a world champion just like everybody else. And hopefully, you know, get through the 14th, and we'll talk about it after that.
So I see you're wearing the SNAC hat. They're one of your sponsors. You want to go ahead and give them a shout out?
I just want to give a big shout out to Victor Conti, to the whole snack team. You know, not a lot of, you know, and Ernie from Everlast, and also Mike Rodriguez, you know, from War Tape. He's the one that connected me with them. You know, there's not a lot of times you see in boxing a lot of people that give and don't expect anything back. You know, Victor Conti, I mean, never met him. You know, I've just talked to him, you know, on Twitter or whatever, but he's helped me out so much already in my career. It's amazing, you know.
Ernie Gabion and Mike Rodriguez are well-respected people in the sport.
Yeah, you know, Mike Rodriguez, you know, he always sends me War Tape, you know, connect me with the snack, and, you know, he's always checking up on me, you know. So I'm just very grateful for him, people like him, Ernie from Everlast, you know, Victor Conti, all my sponsors, you know. So we're just very, 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 very blessed.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Arnold Barboza, trying to close the year strong against Manny Lopez on December 14th, Corpus Christi, Texas. His fight will be televised on ESPN. Thank you very much, Arnold. We'll talk to you after the fight.
Thanks, Oz.